What's going on, everyone? Welcome to my channel, and if you're new here, this is just an E91 328xi build, which is right behind me. And if you're a returning subscriber, you already knew that. So again, to you, welcome back. So today, basically what I'm going to be doing is it's going to be another short and sweet video about my big brake kit and what I put on. So these are 135i/M performance brakes. I bought them used off of a 135i. They're in rough condition, not in the sense of the brakes not working. They were just all chipped up from the factory gray paint that it came with, but I already knew what I was going to be doing with it. Hopefully the wind is not getting through, because as you can see here, I have my handy dandy mic, so it should be better in all the audio. So let's get to it. So as you can see here, I have my car parked up so beautifully, and just the M Sport exterior and interior is coming along so well. I absolutely love this car, and still remaining pre-LCI, it's fantastic. And it's just, you know, everyone converts over to LCI, but I know I'm going off on a tangent. I'm just so obsessed with my car. I absolutely love the looks. But let's get down to the brake kit. I'm gonna start off from front to back, and then you guys know everything what I've done to this to acquire these beautiful brakes on my car. So let me get a close-up on that for you. So as you can see here, I went with a candy red powder coat. This is from Prismatic Powders online. I bought the actual powder coat for, like, it was a pound for $20. And then I had my friend Josh at APS Automotive. He actually is the one who powder coated for me, but I'm the one who actually sandblasted them. They came with that BMW sign on it from the 135i, if you're not familiar with it. Look those up online. You can see they all basically come off the Sport Pack 135i's. If not, I'm not familiar with it so much, but I think they come on most 135i's, if not all. But as you can see here, I have a blank rotor on here, and then the things that I got to, you know, for the actual brake itself, for the both left and right, I bought 4 brand new brake pad screws right here. The other ones, they were a little bit stripped, so I bought brand new ones. I needed to do that because I like having all nice hardware. And of course, you can see with the clip there, they were still in good condition. They were just, of course, had a lot of brake dust on it. So I cleaned that off. I actually sandblasted that, cleaned it off, and wire brushed it. And so it's all good to go. So these are a Porsche design. It's either, it's a 36 mil piston, then it goes to a 34, then to a 28. I probably got those wrong because I had all the numbers in my head, and now all of a sudden when I'm making this video, they went away. But don't quote me on that. So what the problem with a lot of these brakes, the 135i/M performance brakes, are that these crack under high heat. So people don't get the basic brake pedal response that they like. So they tend to get a little bit warped, and you start to feel like a sponge in your brake pedal. So what I did is I upgraded these pistons from Beamer World. And I also paired that with Beamer World stainless steel brake lines, and the brake pedal on my car feels amazing compared to stock. On stock, I tried out, you know, Hawk brake pads. Of course, when I switched over, I had street pads and those race pads, Hawk pads, and they did upgrade. I mean, if you're not really tracking your car a lot or anything like that, then that's more than suitable for, you know, spirited driving and sometimes track days if you're not going hard. But since I do track my car, I know it hasn't been a while, but I do track it every so often and autocross it. I wanted to go with a six piston front and a dual piston in the rear, which I will get to later in the video. But back to these, that's all that I've done for the front. So I did the front, or the, I got all driver's side and passenger side, the brake guide screws right there. And then I upgraded the pistons, both driver and passenger side. As you would know, I wouldn't do it on one than the other. So I no longer have to worry about, and they're actually lighter than the stock ones. Not by much. I think I weighed in total, it saved around, I think, 2 to 3 pounds, which I know it's not a lot, but hey, I went up to big brake kit. So any weight savings is great. And of course, I have this big old gal right here that's already fat. So gotta line her up as much as possible. So now on to the rear. So for these, it's a different story. I tried to find blanks. I really love running blanks on my cars, but since that wasn't applicable, I tried three of them. I tried the 135 I rotors. I tried the Z4 35 rotor, and I tried an X5 rotor. All those were blanks and they did not fit. They just did not go over the hub. The hub is really weird in here. So as you can see here, this is short and that's short. And most of the times this piece right here in the front was longer than it was in the rear. So it just didn't work and I had to go for the M Performance. And on top of that, when I was ready to purchase the whole kit, there was no M Performance rotors available due to the pandemic, which I don't know why we're still having that issue, but we're still having that issue. So I was lucky enough to grab a set for the rear, and I will get to all the pricing at the end of the video. And so don't worry about what I paid for these just yet. And then for everything else that I bought on here, they didn't come with the rattle clips. So I definitely purchased those for both sides. So bought those, and then I was able to clean up the actual pins. As you can see here, I cleaned those up. They were still in good condition, just needed a nice clean. Of course, sandblasted and wire brushed them, and they look brand new. And then of course I added a nice Brembo sticker, which, because they are made by Brembo, they were actually partnered with BMW on these kits. So, and of course, I should have put on a Porsche sticker on them, since it is a Porsche design. This is a Porsche setup, so maybe I'll do that in the future just to mess with people and hopefully get them mad, because I like making people mad when they, you know, they want their opinion or anything like that. But anyways, let's go on to the last thing, which is
price. Okay, well, before I even reveal the price, comment down below of what you guys think. You know, pause the video. Don't be any cheaters out there, okay? So comment down below what you guys think that I actually purchased these brakes for, everything included, all in all. But I have the little cheat sheet right here. Of course, I didn't pull out all my receipts because I have a lot of receipts for what I've done with these. So let's get down to it. So for a total of everything, I paid $2,185, and yikes, that is a lot. But when you come to think about it, just for an actual, you know, 380 mil big brake kit in the front, that's already that price. They go for around 1,800 to 2,000 for the good ones. So, you know, it was well worth it because it has absolutely changed the feel of the car. And yes, I know you're probably saying, Max, why didn't you just buy them brand new? I didn't want to buy them brand new. I wanted to actually build these calipers because I know brand new for a starting price, I think on ECS tuning, they're like $2,200 and they range to $2,500 someplace else. And on top of that, I would replace the pistons. And then that's another, you know, that was another, I actually have everything broken down on this piece of paper. So going back to buying an actual kit, I didn't want to do that. I didn't need to do that because I knew what I wanted to do with my application my specific application, because I wanted to do it myself and I wanted to have it the way how I like it. So I was willing to put in the work and the, you know, and more than anything else was the effort and time. So that's what I knew that I needed to do. But for the brakes themselves, I purchased that for $700, which is pretty good steal. You can't really find these for less than $900. So I bought them for $700 and they range from $900 to, you know, sometimes $1,500 if they're in mint condition and they already come with pads and all that stuff. But I don't like reusing that, so I bought them brand new through FCP. But for the actual like pistons themselves from Beamer World, I bought them for $325 and that was including just the front, you know, pistons, the seals on the inside of the actual pistons as well. There's that seals. If you haven't seen that video, you'll know what I'm talking about. So go back and watch that video. It's on actually my big brake kit playlist, so you can go take a look at that. But that was including the stainless steel brake lines, pistons for the front, all the seals. That was for $325. And for the rear pistons and seals, that was actually $100, so that wasn't bad. But the rear rotors were actually the most expensive. Since it was a BMW part number, it was pretty pricey. And that was actually for $345 just themselves. That's the part that killed me the most. And $335 $335 for the front rotors and the front pads and the rear pads. I didn't need to reuse my sensors since those were still brand new from the first brakes that I did brakes and rotors on my car, brake pads and rotors on my car when I first bought it, because it was a maintenance item for me and they needed it badly. So I already upgraded that, so I didn't need to purchase the sensors. They worked with the one, all the sensors work for all the E-Series models, supposedly. That's what I saw on FCP Euro. So I would just verify before, if you're gonna still do the swap, just verify before. You know, it's always good to double and triple check on that. And then last but not least, all the miscellaneous parts. So the little bolts here and there, the seals, so on and so forth, all the little miscellaneous items. I just rounded it to 300, really wasn't that much, but I'm just making sure. And then it was just $80 for the actual powder to powder coat my brake calipers. I paid $80 for the material and for the work, so it wasn't that bad. But of course, I put in the work to sandblasting. It could be more. So this is just going to be, expect this range. If you're not looking to upgrade anything like that, then of course it's going to be way cheaper with the pistons if you're not looking to upgrade, and it's more mainly for aesthetic. Which, if you guys are going for aesthetic, I really wouldn't suggest going this route, because you can just get 335i calipers, paint them up really nicely, and throw them on. And yes, a lot of people have also said to go to F-Series calipers, which I did think of doing that in the beginning, but with that, I didn't want to do that because the parts are still brand new. And yes, they do look beautiful, but I was gonna just get the M Sport ones, which were the 340, not the 370/380, which not a lot of people know about that. And I possibly still may do the rears in the future, but not really anytime soon, because this kit will be perfectly fine for when I do the diesel swap on my car. It has more than enough grip, and by golly, I've had this kit for about a month and it has stopped on a dime. I just want to stop just because of it. And I have taken it on Spirited Drives and having fun going in the corners and everything like that, and it's done a lot of justice for me. So I'm very happy with this kit. And if you guys are looking to the F-Series, you're probably going to be looking for, if everything is brand new and not used, well, not brand new calipers, but you know, new rotors and pads, more than likely that's going to be ranging between $2,500 to $3,500. So you guys decide on what you want to do, but I was still, regardless or not going to be doing that, because I was only going to this is a 338 mil rotor, and the F-Series ones that I wanted were 340, so it wasn't that worth that price range for me. And of course these work quite well. So that's going to be the end of this video, but of course my finger's in the way, but that's going to be the end of this video. And on to the other videos that I will be making, I'm just going to be making individual part overviews. So next, you know, comment down below what you guys want me to review. Maybe I could review the carbon fiber hood. Maybe I could review coilovers. Maybe I could review, the strut bar installations, and, you know, how the body roll feels, and do an inside cabin overview. And you guys can see how stiff it is, and it's still how comfortable. This car is still comfortable with everything that I've done to it. So, you know, like, comment, subscribe, because now I'm a YouTuber and you gotta do it. I'm a YouTuber. Do it for me, please. But anyways, that will be the end of it. I hope you guys are staying safe out there. Peace.